الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وأسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى to grant his tawfiq and success in the dunya and the akhirah and that he makes us firm upon the way of taqwa and that he includes us into his mercy and into his jannah. We are in the second session from Surah Az-Zumar, we are point number 91 from this noble book from our noble Shaykh, where he talks about the nobility of the people of taqwa. فوائد التقوى من القرآن الكريم, the benefits of taqwa from the noble Quran. And we are now on point number 91, where he says أنها من أسباب النجاة من المهالك والسلامة من السوء. Taqwa is a means for a person to be safe from destruction, and by it is a means of peace and salvation from whatever is bad. Now, in the previous session and in the previous point, the author previously said in point number 90 that the people of taqwa, who have the characteristics of taqwa, will be at the highest level of Allah's Jannah, and they will have the most complete of rewards and enjoyments. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes it clear in Surah Zumar, ayah number 20, لَكِنِ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا رَبَّهُمْ, those who have taqwa of their Lord, لَهُمْ غُرَفًا مِّنْ فَوْقِهَا غُرَفًا مَبْنِيَّةً تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِ الْأَنْهَارُ, they will have apartments and accommodation above them and on top of them, and on top of them they will be built on one another. And they will be made out of gold and silver, and underneath them will be rivers flowing. Imam al-Sa'di in the tafsir of the ayah, he said, لَكِنْ الْغِنَى كُلْ غِنَى, meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says لَكِنْ, meaning after talking about those people who will enter into Allah's punishment, may Allah protect us, لَكِنْ, however, الْغِنَى كُلْ غِنَى وَالْفَوْزْ كُلْ فَوْزْ, all richness, or should I say richness and all richness, and success and all success, للمتقين. Now, Sa'di rahimahullah is saying here that true contentment and richness for the people of taqwa in the dunya and the akhirah, true success for the people of taqwa in the dunya and the akhirah, but they will see that, and it will definitely be made manifest on a day when nobody will have any possessions. للمتقين الذين أعد لهم من كرامة وأنواع النعيم ما لا يقادر قدره, on a day when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will prepare a generosity for them, types of enjoyments and pleasures for them which cannot be measured. We cannot perceive how that will be because it cannot be measured. And that leads us into point number 91, is that from a way of a person attaining salvation from the opposite of that, which is destruction, and salvation and a peace and security from everything which is bad and evil, it is through taqwa. Allah says, وَيُنَجِّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will cause them to be successful, the people of taqwa. بِمَفَازَتِهِمْ لَا يَمَسُّهُ السُّوءُ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ, they will be successful because of their taqwa, and Allah will save them. So savior here is the opposite being instilled as well from the thing that you fear. So now through taqwa, not only are you safe from the thing that you fear, but Allah will put you in a place of security and elevation. It could be that Allah just saves some people but not reward them. Or it could be that Allah rewards some people but punish them at the same time. But for the people of taqwa, so it could be that a person enters the fire, then enters into Jannah afterwards. Or it could be that a person is protected from the fire, but he's on al-a'raf, rijal. There will be men on the a'raf, meaning neither here, neither there. Neither in Jannah, neither in the hellfire. Allah protect us. But for the people of taqwa, they will be safe min al-mahalik, from everything which is a destroyer, everything which is a punishment, everything which is foul and a humiliation, and you know, all of these different words that you can use to describe the hellfire, may Allah protect us. Wassalamat min as-su, and a peace and a tranquility and a reassurance and a safety from anything which is bad. Why? We in a jilla, Allah will protect the people of taqwa, and then He will give them بِمَفَازَتِهِمْ لَا يَمَسُهُمُ السُّوءُ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. As-Suddi, one of the ulama of the Salaf, he said, قَالْ بِفَضَائِلِهِمْ وَيَنَجْلَا الَّذِينَ تَقْوَى بِمَفَازَتِهِمْ, meaning Allah will save the people of taqwa with their success, meaning with their virtues. Allah will save them due to their virtues. Ibn Zayd, another one of the Salaf, he said, and this has been mentioned by Ibn Wahb, another one of the Salaf, he said Allah will save them due to the actions that they used to do. بِعَمَالِهِمْ وَالْآخَرُونَ يَحْمِلُونَ أَوْزَارُهُمْ يَوْمُ الْقِيَامَةِ وَمِنْ أَوْزَارِ الَّذِينِ يَدِلُّونَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ إِلْمٍ عَلَى سَاءَ مَا يَزِرُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions this in the Quran and other places. This is the opposite of the people of taqwa. This is the opposite of the people of taqwa. The people of taqwa will be safe because of their taqwa, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guarantee them security from anything which is bad. But the opposite, the people who did not have taqwa, they will not have security as a count of their deeds. So their deeds will be a blame for them, and the deeds for the other people that they influence will be a blame for them also. But for the people of taqwa, they'll be safe from that. So they will not be carrying the burden of other people, their own selves and other people as well. So it could be, may Allah protect us, that the person who is very sinful in the dunya, he will carry the burdens that he has taught his children to have, or his spouse to have, or her spouse to have for that matter as well. And the people around them that they love the most, they influence them in the bad way. So on the day of judgment, because of the lack of taqwa, Allah protect us, there is no najat. There is no security. And there is no salama. And there is no success for these people. May Allah protect us. Or it will be compromised. Or they will enter into Allah's Jannah, but after a frightful experience perhaps. Allah protect us. This is the importance of taqwa. That they will come on the Day of Judgment carrying their own mistakes as well as the mistakes of the people that influenced them. But that's not for the people of taqwa. As Ibn Wahb is mentioning from his Shaykh Ibn Zayd, وَيُنَجِّنَا الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا بِمَفَازَتِهِمْ, Allah will save the people of taqwa because of their success, meaning their deeds. Their deeds will be safe and sound and secure, and it will be banked because of the taqwa that they used to have in the dunya. In the remaining of the ayah number 61 from Az-Zumar, لَا يَمَسُّهُمُ السُّوءُ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. No evil will touch them. Nothing bad will touch them, and they will not have any sense of sadness or depression or anxiety or worry on that day. يقول تعالى ذكره, this is again from Tafsir al-Tabari, يقول تعالى ذكره, may Allah's mention be elevated, لا يمس المتقين من أذى جهنم شيء. They will not experience anything from the punishment of the hellfire. وَهُوَ السُّوءُ الَّذِي أَخْبَرَ جَلَّ ثَنَاهُ أَنَّهُ لَيْمَسُهُمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us here that they will be safe and secure, this is the evil. لَيْمَسُهُمْ السُّوءُ, you know, nothing evil will touch them. This is the evil. Evil is the is a characteristic and a description of the hellfire. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us here, they will not be touched by the hellfire, the people of the taqwa, and they will not feel worried or sad or anxious, because Allah will keep them safe and secure. May Allah make us of them. وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ عَلَى مَا فَاتَهُمْ مِنْ أَعْرَابِ الدُّنْيَا. وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ, they will not feel sad, can also be interpreted for us to then also mean that they will not miss the life of the dunya. They will have no regrets from the life of the dunya. They will not look back and think, you know, I wish I did this, I wish I did that, I wish I worked towards the Jannah, because they've already done that and they've been successful in that. Because they acted upon that whilst they had the chance to do so. إِذْ صَارُوا إِلَىٰ كَرَامَةِ اللَّهِ وَنَعِيمُ الْجِنَانِ. This is because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make it clear to them, and it will be shown to them, that they have Jannah prepared for them and an everlasting bliss. Therefore, in this point here, point number 91, they will be safe from destruction and they will be in a state of security from everything which is bad, meaning they will not, the hellfire will not touch them, and they will not have any anxiety or worries or stress about the hellfire or what they have left behind or you know, whatever has been destroyed and left this dunya, because they are seeing and they are being shown ahead of them is something far greater. Point 92, أَنَّ الْمُتَّقِينَ يُسَاقُونَ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ زُمَرًا سُوقٌ إِكْرَامٌ وَخُلُودٌ. The people of Taqwa will be driven, يساقون, driven, I mean they'll be ushered, probably a better word, to Jannah. They'll be shown the way to Jannah by the Malaika. And they'll enter into Jannah in groups. And as they are ushered into Jannah, shown into Jannah, they are treated with high esteem. They are treated with generosity. They are treated and elevated in their status. They are respected, they are shown respect by the Malaika. And it is a place for them to stay for eternity. From the benefits of Taqwa, from the noble Quran, may Allah make us of them, is that they will be shown the way to Jannah by the Malaika. Imagine an angel telling you this is the way that you need to go. A huge, beautiful being that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created. We've never seen anything like it in our lives. This amazing creature is on our side. This amazing creature is a believer like us. This amazing creature is telling us, go into another creation that you've never ever seen before, never experienced before. This is your place to reside in forever. And they are being kind to you despite their size. They're being kind to you despite them being, you know, perhaps, you know, having more worship than us. Ayah number 73, ayah number 74 from Az-Zumar. Qala ta'ala, what's the proof of this point? وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا رَبَّهُمْ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ زُمَرًا. The people of Taqwa will be taken by their Lord in groups towards Jannah. Meaning the angels will show them the way. حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءُوهَا وَفُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا. Until they get to the doors of Jannah, the doors of Jannah will then be opened. وَقَالَ لَهُمْ خَزَنَتُهَا سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ. It will be then said to them, stay and reside in this place. This is your place to stay forever. Salamun alaykum. Peace be upon you. Tibtum, you have done excellent. Tibtum, you have been pure. Tibtum, you have been the best that you could have been. Fadkhuluha khalidin. Therefore, this is your reward because you were pure there. You are pure now. Enter. وَقَالُوا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي صَدَقَنَا وَعْدَ. What is the response for the people of Taqwa? Just like they say Alhamdulillah in the dunya, they will say Alhamdulillah in the akhirah. وَقَالُوا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي صَدَقَنَا وَعْدَ. Alhamdulillah, Allah spoke the truth and He has fulfilled His promise to us. وَأَوْرَثَنَا الْأَرْضَ. And He has given us the chance to stay in this new land. نَتَبَوَّأُ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ حَيْثُ نَشَاءُ. And we can do and go wherever we want in this jannah. فَنِعْمَ أَجْرُ الْآمِلِينَ. So what a beautiful and excellent reward for those people who did good, meaning the people of Taqwa. In his explanation, Imam Tabari, this is why it's important for us to go back to the books of Tafsir rather than reading for ourselves and trying to understand it in our own way. And, you know, when we go back to the speech of the ulama, they are able to explain it in a way that we perhaps could understand it in our mind, but the way they put it is far better. Look what Imam al-Tabari says. يَقُولْ تَعَلَى ذِكْرَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevated his status. He says, وَحُشِرَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا رَبَّهُمْ. Allah will put together in groups those people who had taqwa. الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا رَبَّهُمْ. They had taqwa of their Lord. How did they have taqwa? بِأَدَى فَرَائِدِهِ وَاجْتِنَاءِ مَعَاصِهِ فِي الدُّنْيَا. They did what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told them to do, and they stayed away from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told them to stay away from in the dunya. Is that enough? No. وَأَخْلَصُوا لَهُ فِيهَا al-uluhiyya wa afraduluhu al-ibadah. Proof for Tawheed al-uluhiyya. Again, proof for the categorization of Tawheed from one of the Imams of the Salaf. They had ikhlas. They had ikhlas internally. This is taqwa. And they did what they were supposed to do, and they stayed away from what they were supposed to do. Externally, this is taqwa. These people will be brought together. They will be grouped together on that day. فَلَمْ يُشْرِكُوا فِي إِبَادَتِهِمْ إِيَّاءُ شَيْئًا. And they didn't have any aspect of shirk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the slightest. They will be brought to Jannah زُمَرًا يعني جماعات, groups after groups. فَكَانَ السُّوق هَؤُلَىٰ إِلَىٰ مَنَازِلِهِمْ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ وَفْدًا. And they will be entered into Jannah as delegates. Delegate after delegate. Group after group. So it's not that, you know, you enter into Jannah because Allah wants you to enter as groups. What He is making it clear for us here, rahimahullah, is that they will enter as groups as a form of them being honored. وَالسُّوقُ الْآخِرِينَ إِلَى النَّارِ دَعًا وَوَرْدًا كَمَا قَالَ تَعَالَى. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in the previous ayat that the people of the hellfire, may Allah protect us, will also be driven into the fire, but that will not have any kind of generosity or any elevation connected to that. Imam Tabari then says, in quoting a narration from Ali ibn Abi Talib, the people of Taqwa will be as delegates in groups entering into Jannah. Imam Ali, radiallahu anhu, Amir al-Mu'mineen, gives us a lengthy description as to what's going to happen on that day. So the people of Taqwa, they've gone across the Sirat and they get to the doors of Jannah. حَتَّى إِذَا انْتَهَوْا إِلَىٰ بَابِهَا إِذَا هُمْ بِشَجَرَةٍ يَخْرُجْ مِنْ أَصْلِهَا عِينًا. As they get to the doors of Jannah, now let's remember, this is a very important principle, is that Imam al-Tabari has said that this narration is acceptable. Would it be possible that Ali radiallahu anhu talks about something of the unseen and the accounts of the judgment from his own deduction and his own ijtihad? The answer is no. Therefore, is a very important principle is that whenever you have a companion speaking about the unseen, especially when it comes from tafsir, then it takes the level of tafsir from the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because all of the companions are trustworthy in what they have taught us from ilm, especially when it comes to the unseen. If it was something from Hukam, that is his own personal opinion, and another person had a different opinion, such as Ibn Masud, for example, he didn't used to raise his hands in Salah, he only used to raise it in the beginning. Whereas more than 50 of the companions used to raise their hands in the beginning, before the ruku', after the ruku'. And there is dispute whether, you know, if it's an action of Ibn Umar after the first tashahhud or not. I mean, this is just an example of how, if there was a view from the companions and they differed in a practical view, that's fair enough. We will understand that this is difference of. But when it comes to something of aqeedah and the unseen, important principle for us to understand is that it takes the ruling of us understanding that he has had this from the Messenger of Allah. So Ali ibn Abi Talib, radiallahu anhu, if this narration is correct, and it appears to be correct, and supported by Imam al-Tabari himself, is that when the people of Jannah enter, or when they get to the doors of Jannah, a tree will come out. It'll come out. بِشَجَرَ يَخْرُجْ مِنْ أَصْلِهَا عَيْنًا. It'll just come out. A tree will come out. And from the roots of that tree will be two springs. They will then head towards one of those springs. And then they will drink from that spring, because the angels will be there telling them to drink from that spring. And it could be understood here, وَسِيكَ الَّذِينَ تَقُوا رَبَّهُمْ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ زُمَرَ حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءُوهَا وَفُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا. Until they get to the doors of Jannah, they will be ushered towards Jannah with the Malaika. They've just crossed the bridge, the most terrifying bridge they've ever seen. They've seen the hellfire, they've gone over the hellfire, and because of their taqwa, they were able to get to the other side. The angels are now meeting them at the other side, and now they are ready to show them their way to Jannah. But before that happens, a tree comes out and there's a spring there. And the angels then tell them, drink, drink. When they drink, this Ali is saying here, فَخَرَجَ مَا فِي بُطُونِهِمْ مِنْ قَدَرْ أَوْ أَذَىٰ أَوْ قَدَىٰ. When they drink, anything which was, you know, of undesired, let's say, anything which was bad internally, spiritually, physically, it will then leave them. Anything harmful would leave them. Anything undesired would leave them. ثُمَّ عَمَدُوا إِلْ أُخْرَى. Then they will go to the other spring. فَتَوَدَّأُوا مِنْهَا. And then they will make wudu from it as they had been ordered to do so. So the angels will say, go to the other one, make wudu. فَجَرَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ نَضْرَةُ النَّعِيمِ. So they will make wudu, and then Ali ibn Abi Talib said, فَجَرَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ نَضْرَةُ النَّعِيمِ. Then the faces will start to illuminate. And their hair and their heads will not have any impediments anymore. The grayness will go, وَلَن تُبْلَى ثِيَابَهُمْ بَعْدَهَا. And their clothes will be cleaned, and there will be no marks or anything. ثُمَّ دَخَلُوا الْجَنَّةِ. In that state now of internal and external cleansing, cleaning, purification, beautification, then they will enter into Jannah. And when they enter into Jannah, this is not the statement of Ali, but we can say now that when they enter into Jannah, the ayah clearly tells us, وَفُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا وَقَالَ لَهُمْ خَزَنَتُهَا سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ. As they enter, the angels are saying, سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ. Enter, this is your place of residence forever. تِبْتُمْ. You've done excellent, well done, congratulations. فَدْخُلُهَا خَالِدِينَ. Stay in here forever. Ali radiallahu anhu, in ayah number 74, وَقَالَ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي صَدَقَنَا وَعْدَ. Until the end, the people of Taqwa will say, Alhamdulillah, Allah fulfilled his promise to us. Goes on with his account of what will happen on that day. May Allah make us of them. ثُمَّ دَخْلُوا الْجَنَّةِ. Then they will enter into Jannah. And they will meet small children, beautiful looking children, كَأَنَّهُمْ لُؤْلُهُ الْمَكْنُونَ, as if they were preserved pearls. فيقولون أبشر عد الله لك كذا وعد الله كذا وكذا. And those little children, those beautiful little children, will grab the people of Jannah by their hands and they say, come, 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 good news, Allah has given you this, and Allah has given, come on, have a look, come on, come on. ثم ينظر إلى تأسيس بنيانه. Then he will look at his house, and he will begin by looking at it from bottom up. And surrounding his house will be lu'lu, al-ahmar, wal-asfar, wal-akhtar. There will be red pearls, yellow pearls, and green pearls. Now, this is important because a person might ask, well, I don't really like pearls, and my favorite color is not red or green. Brothers and sisters, important for us to understand that whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes something from the unseen, it only matches something from the seen by name. So the fire in the dunya is not the fire in the akhirah. Red in the dunya is not the red of the akhirah. The green of the dunya is not the green of the akhirah. The pearl of the dunya is not a pearl of the boy of the dunya is not the boy of the akhirah. The door of the dunya is not the door of the akhirah. The bridge of the dunya is not the bridge of the akhirah. The list goes on. Anything that has been mentioned of the unseen, it only resembles it by names. وَأُتُوبِهِ مُتَشَابِهَا. As Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu said in the tafsir of the ayah, وَأُتُوبِهِ مُتَشَابِهَا. When they look at those pearls, the foundation of their home, pearls of red and yellow and green. يتلألأ كأنه البرق. It will illuminate. It will be sparkling, should we say, probably better. يتلألأ, it will be sparkling like the intensity of lightning. فلولا أن الله قضى أن لا يذهب بصره لذهب. Had Allah not previously ordained and not made, you know, in other words as well, not made your body being able to withstand that kind of a reward, you would have lost your eyesight by looking at it. Remember, lightning of the dunya is not like the lightning of the akhirah. ثُمَّ يَأْتِي بَعْدُهُمْ إِلَى بَعْدِ أَزْوَاجِهِ. Then, as he enters his home, he will meet his wife, she will meet her husband. And the man will say to the wife, أَبْشِرِي قَدْ قَدَمَ فُلَان إِبْنُ فُلَان. قَدْ قَدَمَ فُلَان إِبْنُ فُلَان. فَيُسَمِّي بِإِسْمِهِ وَإِسْمِ أَبِيهِ. And now they are beginning to reunite. There's a reunion that's going on. Good news, you are here. Good news, this person is here. Oh, you know who else is here? And they will say, أَنْتَ رَأَيْتُ أَنْتَ رَأَيْتُ. And they will say, have you seen this person? Have you seen this? فيستخفها الفرح حتى تقوم فتجلس على أسكفه بابها. He will then meet with the people and there will be a lot of joy, etc. And then he will enter eventually into his home and he will sit perhaps with these people in his home, in his residence, etc. فيدخل فيتكي على سريره. And then as he enters, furniture after furniture, mats after mats, pillows after pillows, couches after couches, sofas after sofas, and he will enter and he will relax on that sofa. And then he will say the ayah that Allah mentions in the Quran, Alhamdulillahi alladhi hadana li hadha. Alhamdulillah, all praise and thanks to Allah with perfection and completion and love, who has guided us to this. وَمَا كُنَّا لِنَهْتَدِي لَوْلَا أَنْ هَدَانَ اللَّهِ. We would not have been able to get to this location, this position and this status by ourselves. In this ayah, وَقَالُوا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي صَدَقَنَا وَعْدَهُ. Alhamdulillah, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us what He has promised us. وَأَوْرَثَنَا الْأَرْضَ نَتَبَوَّأُ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ حَيْثُ نَشَأُ. And He has given us a land which we have inherited, where we can have whatever we want. فَنِعْمَ أَجْرُ الْآمِنِينَ. What a great reward for those people who did good. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us tawfiq, to grant us taqwa, and that He accepts it from us and He makes us of those people who are illuminated in the dunya and more importantly in the akhirah. Hada wallahu a'lam, sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.